I'm Norman Wildberger, and today we're going to look at an aspect of projective geometry involving the relationship between points and lines. We're going to also have a chance to review some very fundamental geometry in three-dimensional space. Because our approach is that the projective plane should be thought of as consisting of lines and planes in three-dimensional space. So here's the usual setup for space. We have a coordinate system with an x-axis, a y-axis, and a z-axis. A point in three-dimensional space, say that one there, called P, given by coordinates A, B, and C, is visualized by going A in the direction x, B in the direction y, and C in the direction z. And we visualize everything by a parallelogram, A in this direction, B in this direction, C in this direction. So that is the point with coordinates A, B, and C. Now, what's going to be important for us in projective geometry is the line through the origin and this point P, that line in green there. That line in green is only determined by A, B, and C up to a factor. So it's really the proportion between A and B and C that counts. And so we're going to call the line A to B to C, that proportion A to B to C. And what's also going to be important for us today is talking about planes in three-dimensional space, also through the origin. So here I've drawn in red a plane through the origin, which is perpendicular to the line that we've started with. This plane, because it's determined by this direction A, B, C, is going to be given by this notation. Pointed brackets A to B to C. And it has an ordinary equation of the form ax plus by plus cz equals 0. In other words, any point x, y, and z that lies on this plane satisfies this relation. And conversely, everything that satisfies this relation is a point on the plane. And our first order of business is to convince you that this equation exactly describes the plane that is perpendicular to the point A, B, C, or perpendicular to that vector emanating from O to P. So let's review a few things about three-dimensional geometry. Here's our coordinate system as before, and the point P with coordinates A, B, and C. If we drop a perpendicular down onto the xy plane, we'll call that point R. The quadrants between O and R from this right triangle is a squared plus b squared. This includes the possibility that a or b might be negative as well. Once we have this quadrants here, then we see that there's another right triangle going up to p. Since this is c or plus or minus c, this quadrants from o to p will be the quadrants we've just found, a squared plus b squared plus c squared. So the quadrants between o and p with coordinates A, B, and C is the sum of the squares, A squared plus B squared plus C squared. That's how we describe quadrants in three-dimensional space. And now let's have a look at a general situation. We have a point O here, our point P, A, B, C here, our point X, X, Y, Z here. From what we just said, this quadrants is A squared plus B squared plus C squared. And this quadrants is X squared plus Y squared plus Z squared. The quadrants between these two points is given by a similar formula where we have to use the difference between the coordinates of P and X. So it's A minus X squared plus B minus Y squared plus C minus Z squared. And now we're interested in the perpendicularity here. In other words, when Pythagoras' theorem is going to hold. Pythagoras' theorem would be this quadrants plus this quadrants equals that quadrants. So that gives the long equation that this quadrants, a squared plus b squared plus c squared, plus this quadrants, x squared plus y squared plus z squared, equals this quadrants. And now when you write this out and expand the right-hand side, you see that you also get an a squared plus b squared plus c squared over here. And you also get an x squared plus y squared plus z squared over here, and they cancel exactly what's on the left. And then all that's remained after you divide by 2 is the cross terms here, ax plus by plus cz equals 0. So that's why this linear equation between the x, y, z coordinates and the a, b, c coordinates expresses perpendicularity between the vector OP and the vector OX. In other words, it really does describe the equation of a plane perpendicular to the line OP through the origin. And now let's put everything together. Here's our three-dimensional space. And here, z equals 1, that's a plane parallel to the xy plane up unit 1. That's our viewing plane, the plane that we actually think of as the projective plane. And here we have a line through the origin, a central line. And here we have a plane through the origin, a central plane. And what we're going to be interested in is where those lines and planes intersect our viewing projective plane. The line with coordinates A to B to C intersects our viewing plane at the point with coordinates A over C, B over C, 1, because we have to divide by C to get the Z coordinate equal to 1. The perpendicular plane here with equation AX plus BY plus CZ equals 0, what we're calling pointy brackets A to B to C, that's going to intersect this plane in the place where we set the z coordinate equal to 1. So in terms of the coordinates capital X and capital Y on this plane, we get a line with equation AX plus BY plus C equals 0. So to summarize, a projective point is notationally given by square brackets A to B to C. And it can be identified with the planar point whose capital X and capital Y coordinates are A over C and B over C. That's provided C is not equal to 0. And a projective line, which is something that's given by pointy brackets A to B to C, corresponds to the standard line AX plus BY plus C equals 0 in ordinary X, Y space. That's provided that A and B are both not equal to 0. So these are the fundamental objects in projective geometry: the projective point, the projective line, and this description makes the symmetry between these two things obvious. Algebraically, projective points and projective lines are almost exactly the same, except that we're enclosing one in square brackets and enclosing the other in pointed brackets. Next time we're going to have a look at affine geometry, which is closely related to the problem of putting coordinates on the projective plane. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.